Well, I'd always liked to draw. From a little thing, I was a little kid, and so I just kept on doing that all the way through. And I never really did much art in high school, but at some point when I decided that I was going to go to university and I was thinking about a major, I thought I would try art because I wanted to be approved in art. That would be my first year, whatever, back in 1973. And the first year, you know, it was a bit bumpy here and there because I actually didn't have much experience as a lot of the other kids in the first year. And I wasn't as disciplined as I might have been. But it was around the second year, my sophomore year, that I began to think this is really a cool thing to do. And I'd also really realized that the university was the kind of environment to do it in. So I got more and more engaged with them. By the time I graduated, I was confident enough that I wanted to be an artist to enter into a graduate program which to be an artist. And from that, this is what it's always done. Hard question, because it was taken for granted. I do think it's another way of thinking about stuff, and it's really active. You're thinking of your whole person in your plan. So on an individual basis, it's, I think, a very good thing that people can do. So it's up to it. On a collective basis, it's really engage a lot of people. You'd think, you know, given the digital technology at our disposal, making hands-on art, making the kind of thing we can have in the field. But every time we have an exhibition opening, handmade art, people come like to go on the night and go off and go so something about it that people really respond to and can engage with it, and it feeds people. One on the level of personal influences, like, you know, teachers and such. There were still teachers I had as an undergrad who, you know, I could sort of hear them kind of in the back of my mind, you know, their names won't be familiar to anyone, but I had a very good drawing teacher with David Chickies, who was an excellent other guy. Dick Lee was also very good. And then, of course, my ceramic instructor as well. As to other influences, I guess I was very enamored of the 1950s. Also continually explored, because I teach art history, of course. I talk about art from many different times of art. And I find often something I see in an art group that might be hundreds of years old will give me an idea for something I want to do. Artists generally tend to absorb ideas, you know, from the environment they're in. And if the environment is image rich, then they are able to absorb that and synthesize it. Develop something beats for them. I guess by that I mean, not that other things don't. I have a family and with my dad and my auntie, of course, and my friends too. But it's something that helps me process the world. Part of why it's hard to answer is that I can't imagine not doing it. A friend of mine says,